Hello everyone, welcome. In this episode, we are going to learn how to create an asynchronous function and how asynchronous function is different from the normal functions. So let's start from the scratch. Let's create a project called Hello Async. Let's go to our VS Code editor and open that project, Hello Async. And what we can do, go to the terminal and what we can initialize the project. We are just following the convention. This is our SRC module. Let's write here main.js. Back to focus, let's create a function. Let hello. This is normal function and this function is returning hello world. RM. Can you call this function? You can call this function like this. And since this function is returning something, we can store that value in a variable output and we can print the value. Now, can we run this program? Let's run this program src main.js. Let's observe the output. The output of this function is what? Hello world. And the function is normal function. Now, how to create an asynchronous function? Or how do you make an existing function as an asynchronous function? By using a keyword async. So async keyword, if we apply the async keyword before any function, that function becomes what? Asynchronous. Now let's try to run this program and try to observe the output. What is the output? The output of an asynchronous function is always a promise. So when we get the term promise, when we are working with an asynchronous function, an asynchronous function always return a promise. And now let's learn how to resolve the output. That is how to get the actual output like this hello world from a promise object. Okay, now I'm renaming this variable output and calling this what? M promise. Why I'm calling this M promise? See, it is a returning a promise object. So I'm keeping the variable name a similar like that. And a promise has a two state. It has a two state. Either it has to be successful or it has to be failure. That means this asynchronous function should successfully execute or there should be some error in this asynchronous function. So if the state is success, how to handle the success? M promise dot then. This then block is used to resolve the output from a when the operation is success. So this takes what? Again a callback. Okay, I'm calling this data and let's console the output, console.log. So let's run the program one more time and see the output. So we are able to successfully resolve the output from a promise object. How? By using the keyword, by using the then function. How do we use then function? We apply the then function on the promise. And if we want to handle, let's suppose an error, so we call catch and here error console.log error. Let's suppose because of some reason some error happens here in this program. Suppose manually I am throwing some error. Okay, throw new error. So now what will happen? This line will never execute and this asynchronous function will always return an error. So where this, how we will resolve that error? By using catch. Let's run this program. Now where the call is going? The call is going to what? Error block. Anyway, that is what, just a simulation purpose. Okay, so what we have done, we have created an asynchronous function. That asynchronous function always return a promise and now we know how to handle the promise, a success and failure. Now let's go ahead. and let's create another program and understand further things. main1.js. In this main1.js, I just want you to know that this then and catch block, this then and catch method can be chained. So sometimes people write like this. You do not have to write it separately, but they can write dot catch. So they are chaining the method, both then and catch. And again, the exception handling is not optional. So you might find that people are writing the handling the promise like this. Handling the promise, that is the output from the asynchronous, like this. Or even this can be further optimized. How the people are writing the program? They are writing the program like this. Okay, they are not even using this keyword and promise. So how they are writing? Hello. Instead of this, we are writing hello. So what is the meaning? This hello method is returning what? This hello method is asynchronous. And we know that what is the output of the asynchronous method? The output of the asynchronous method is what? Promise. And to successfully handle the output of the promise or the output of the asynchronous function, this then block will be called, and the failure of the asynchronous function will call this catch block. Okay, now let's run this program one more time, just show you the output. Note src main. Okay, we can call this 1.js. Okay, so before concluding the session, we might be thinking that what is the advantage of the asynchronous function? The advantage of the asynchronous function is what? It's a non-blocking in nature, and we can apply this in several examples. Okay, like whenever we are making a network call or whenever we are making a database call, we don't want to block our main execution, that is main thread. So creating an asynchronous function is always a advantage. Okay, that's it from this session. See you in the next video. Thank you.